What's up, guys? Welcome back to Paul's Hardware. This is my May installment for GPU Price Watch 2025 because GPU prices are too damn high and we're looking at them closely, hoping that they will come down. And short answer first, have they come down? Well, similar to last month, the answer is yes, but only slightly.
Excellent!
Today's video is brought to you by Thermaltake's View 380 XL Tempered Glass ARGB Mid-Tower Chassis. With an innovative dual-chamber design and angled front intake to direct airflow towards components, keeping even power-hungry high-end PC builds cool while maintaining an unobstructed view. Hey, that's why it's called the View 380. Keep things clean with hidden connector motherboard support, keep cool with four included ARGB fans and multiple radiator mount locations for up to 360mm AIOs, and have fun building with plenty of room for cable management and added storage. For more on the View 380 XLTG ARGB from Thermaltake, click the sponsor link in the video description. All right, so getting right into it, here's my GPU price watch list for April, and here is the price watch list for May. As you can probably tell, I've expanded it a little bit because we have the RTX 5060 8GB that has launched, and I've also added Intel Arc GPUs down there at the bottom because, honestly, my Intel rep hit me up and was like, hey, why are you doing GPU price watch and you're just leaving Intel out of it? My answer is because the stupid B580 and B570s, which I would happily recommend for their MSRPs down in the sub $250 range, are still costing over $300, or at least pretty dang close to it, with an MSRP markup that is tough to stomach when you compare it to slightly better options that are on the market. Now, quick notes on my methodology. I am pulling all of my data from PC Part Picker, and I am looking at the cheapest prices per GPU. I'm grabbing both the lowest price option that I can find on the market, and then I'm averaging the cheapest 10 prices on the market to get our average. And I'm also going in and validating because some of these prices that are listed are not actually available. So while I would love to say that the cheapest RTX 9070 XT, I wouldn't love to say that the cheapest 9070 XT is $720, but that would be the cheapest one, but it's not even that because it's out of stock, which means the next cheapest option jumps up to $840. Also, a word of warning to anyone who is out there trying to shop for the cheapest price, keep an eye out for third-party marketplace sellers. On Amazon, for example, you can see that listed over here, who it is shipped from and sold by. There are regular scammers who list GPUs for much lower than they should be. You should check the store you're buying from and their feedback rating. PC Parts Sales here, for example, I would say probably okay. They at least have sold some stuff. They have some feedback saying that they were actually selling viable hardware. But if the seller you find here is brand new and has never sold anything before, especially if the price seems too good to be true, it's probably gonna be a scam. And if you place an order, it's probably not actually gonna ship to you. And if something does ship to you, it's probably not gonna be the thing that you ordered. This also applies to Newegg, by the way. It'll say down here who it is sold by. Again, they at least have a seller feedback rating system that you can put in place. And I also noticed that Newegg is now adding this, a pricing notice for GPUs that are priced notably above what their MSRP should be, like a 9070 XT selling for $1,200 freaking. Newegg is slightly dissociating themselves from these sellers by saying, Newegg is committed to providing value-driven pricing to our customers. This item is offered by a third-party marketplace seller and its price is set independently from our own. We've noticed lower prices for the same product from some other sellers on our platform. So obviously, it's not Newegg's fault that these are overpriced. All they're doing is providing these sellers with a platform to continue selling overpriced goods on their platform. Not Newegg's fault at all. We can't blame them. Getting back to kind of a high-level overview of this chart, though, if you want my quick assessment of where the value lies, if you really need to buy a graphics card right now, my advice is still try to hold off if you can, because we can see prices continuing to drop slightly, ever so slightly, over time. And I will say that there are a handful of cards that are only 10% or so marked up over MSRP. Those are most notably the 5060 Ti 16GB, the 5070, and the 5070 Ti. Last month, it was only the 5070 that was kind of down in this range where I said, if you gotta buy something right now, that seems to be the best value for your money. But I am glad to say that the 5070 Ti and the 5060 Ti are at least downward trending in price back towards MSRP. Again, a $50, $55, $88 markup over MSRP is a little bit tough to stomach, but it's, again, by comparison, not quite as bad. And these are current generation cards, RTX 50 series, that have access to all the fancy bells and whistles, including like multi-frame generation, DLSS 4.0, which I don't think is a bad thing in and of itself. It's just bad when they say multi-frame generation is the same as natively rendered frames. But all right, let's do what I've done before and kind of go down the list from the top to the bottom. I'm gonna spend less time on the RTX 40 series this time around because honestly, the value that's available on the 50 series makes these 40 series prices, even though they have come down a little bit, but these simply are not recommendable. An RTX 4060 8GB should not be bought for $340 when the RTX 5060 8GB, which is a better card even though it's still hamstrung by its 8GB VRAM buffer, is available for $40 less. The RTX 40 series is also no longer in production, so while these green numbers here might look slightly good, I will point out that a lot of the average prices have gone up month over month. Like the 4070 going from $915 to $930 on average, or the 4080 Super going from $1805 to $1890. I also thought it was interesting that the RTX 4090 is continuing to increase in price. I would say that's probably the knock-on effect of this card still being desirable for AI usage, which probably is still maintaining its demand. Another trend that I've noticed with some of these GPUs is that the best price is actually not available from a retailer like Newegg or Amazon. Like the best price 4060 8GB was direct from Asus for $340. Not a good price, don't buy it. But again, just something I thought was fairly interesting. Now the RTX 5060 8GB just recently launched last week during Computex. And if you watch my Computex coverage, you might have seen my video where I was not very happy with Nvidia for how they rolled out this launch. I got some feedback on that video from people saying, "Paul, I really need a graphics card. This is like the best viable option within my price range for around $300. So I'm sorry, even though you're mad at Nvidia and recommending not buying this graphics card, I still need to buy it." And I want to clarify something. My reason for being upset with Nvidia was a lot more with how they dealt with this launch and how they treated reviewers with this launch versus the actual performance of the card. I think they're detracting from neutral discussion of their graphics card by how they're handling the launch and how they're treating reviewers, specifically by holding back the driver from the majority of reviewers who are going to be doing objective reviews and only allowing a handful of outlets who are willing to go along with Nvidia's guidelines for how to review the card to show it in the best light possible, which I found to be just incredibly disingenuous and frustrating and going against the way the review process has always worked in the past, which is to provide day one reviews, or ideally a day before day one reviews, so people can look, see the performance, and then make an informed buying decision, rather than only being able to view a handful of cherry-picked reviews from reviewers who are willing to go along with Nvidia's scheme. Fortunately, Steve over at Hardware Unboxed was able to bring his testing equipment along with him to Computex, so he was able to post this day one review, which is linked in the video's description. And like, it really sucks that Nvidia did what they did, because looking at these results, the 5060 8GB is not absolutely horrible. The best explanation I can give for why Nvidia did what they did was maybe they didn't want people with like a 3060 Ti or a 4060 Ti or like a 6700 XT or something in that range looking at the 5060 and being like, "Oh, well, clearly I do not need to upgrade to this card because it's not a good value." It is notable that the RTX 5060 8GB is going to perform better at 1080 because once you jump up to 1440, that VRAM buffer starts to affect it more. So here, for example, the Intel Arc B580 is like within a couple frames of the 5060 8GB. Again, showing frustratingly how easily recommendable the B580 would be at its MSRP of $250. But hey, when you're making that comparison at 310 versus 300, if you're frustrated with Nvidia or if you're just looking for something that gives you more VRAM because you don't want to be limited by that 8GB capacity, a B580 12GB for $10 more might be something that you would consider. But I feel like you would have to be taking the principle of the thing into account as well there. But anyway, I don't want to dwell too much on the poor rollout of the 5060 8GB launch. To its credit, you can buy them right now for $300, which is the MSRP. And while we should not have to give credit to our GPU manufacturers for just doing what they said they would do, I guess that's kind of where we're at. And again, just like that Asus card, the only one that's available right now is actually being sold directly from MSI, which is a slightly interesting development, I would say, for this launch. I wonder if that's going to be a continued trend going forward. If you watched the Gamers Nexus tariffs video, you know that there is a retail tax that gets put on cards that are sold at retail. Retailers do offer some value to manufacturers because they handle the sales, the logistics, the communication with the customer, often the RMA support if the product needs to be returned. But if manufacturers are able to set up direct customer sales portals and they're functional enough and they get the product shipped out quickly enough, if they have the logistics lined up, that might be a way for them to keep costs down closer to MSRP. So that's going to be something that I continue to look at as I continue this series next month. Next up, the 5060 Ti 8GB. Cheapest price is $420, which is a $40 markup, about 10.5%. This one, like the 5060 8GB, falls into that 8GB trap where if you really want to be a little bit more protected for forward compatibility, longevity, for using your GPU with like a monitor upgrade that you might get if you're, you know, upgrading from 1080 to 1440 or something like that, I'd say definitely claw your way up to a 16GB 5060 Ti. And either way, you're still gonna be paying about 10% over MSRP. The 5070 12GB was my recommendation if you really need to buy a GPU right now, last month, and the lowest price on that has dropped by $15 or so, down to $605. And that means that, apart from the 5060 8GB, it wins the NVIDIA least marked up over MSRP award at just a flat 10%. Continuing on up the stack, the 5070 Ti is a 16GB card, which does put it in the same class as like the 5080, and I guess maybe the 7800 XT, at least in terms of the VRAM buffer. So again, here I'm glad that the lowest price has dropped by $62. That makes it an $88 markup over MSRP. That's a nice improvement from last month for anyone who wasn't getting by with the 5070. And I would say especially compared to the 5080 16GB, which seems to be getting a little bit of that halo knock-on effect from like the top tier cards like the 5090 and 4090. Because it is the best NVIDIA graphics card right now that doesn't cost $200, it seems like there is some desirability on the market there, possibly. Still though, just not a good value at close to 40% markup over MSRP. And again, that one's trending in the wrong direction. The cheapest one has gone up in price instead of down. Now, I'm dealing with US-based prices here, but if you've been following the news, you might have noticed that in places outside of the US, EU for example, prices have actually been coming down even more, and that may or may not have to do with the tariff situation here. But again, if you're looking for some slightly good news, if you're trying to paint the most glowing picture possible, the low price for the 5090 32GB dropped $443, from close to $3,400 in April to less than $3,000 in May. The average price is also trending down month to month, so it does seem like the 5090s are slightly coming back to reality, even though in reality $2,000 plus for a graphics card is still quite absurd, and they are still getting a 46% markup. All right, let's move on to the AMD Radeon side. I was looking at the 7800 XT. I also checked the 7900 GRE, but those are just in such short supply right now. It's worth taking a look at. I think I found one for about $750. But overall, on the AMD side, things are not looking very good. The 7800 XT, for example, which is often sold down in the $500 to $550 range and would be a decent recommendation at that price for a 16GB card, but that one has been stagnant with no change month to month and still a 20% markup over MSRP. A reminder once again that the 7900 XT was never a good value at its MSRP of $900, so even though the low price has come down to $683, and it is the only card on this list that is selling for below MSRP, keep in mind that the MSRP was a pipe dream to start with. However, again, however, asterisk, if you're just looking for something to buy and you hate NVIDIA and you need a graphics card right now, and especially if VRAM is a concern, the 7900 XT with 20 gigs of VRAM for $683 is the best value for an AMD card right now and would definitely be a better buy than the stupid 9070s, which is selling for $700 at the cheapest and $840 at the cheapest. And given how close the 7900 XT is to the 7900 XTX, that also kind of blows that out of the water with its cheapest price being $1,000 right now. For our 9070s, cue the Obi-Wan Anakin interaction. You're supposed to be the chosen one. You're supposed to save us, not join the dark side. Still just trending way too hard. It sucks because these are good cards. They're good values at their MSRP. We just gotta wait on AMD, and hopefully they are ramping up production of these now that they've seen how popular that they could be. But absolutely do not buy these cards for this much money. Let's hold out and hope AMD brings their prices down. Lastly, of course, we have the Intel Arc cards, which I've pretty much already discussed. Because they are down close to the $300 range, they are potentially viable alternatives to something like a 5060 8GB, so keep that in mind. But my overall summary here is that, once again, we're just trying to make the best of a bad situation. If you have a functional system with a functional graphics card and you can hold out playing at a lower resolution or with lower settings for the time being, it does seem like things are trending in the right direction, just a lot slower than we would prefer. Who knows if now that the 5060 is on the market, if that's going to start affecting prices down at the lower end. We also have the RX 9060 XT that was just announced at Computex. That's coming out next week, so that will also provide some low low-end competition. So I'm optimistic that the low end of the market is seeing some more competition and some more viable GPUs coming in. And then I'm also hoping that since it's been now 4 or 5, going on 6 months since the beginning of the year, some of those early in the year decisions to like, hey, let's make more GPUs because they're selling very well, might come into play and we might see more availability on the market as a whole. But that is gonna wrap it up for this video, you guys. Thank you so much for joining me. I will be continuing this next month, probably a little bit more towards middle to the late of the month rather than the very end of the month. I had to push things back a little bit this month because of Computex. Speaking of which, if you missed out on any of my Computex coverage, there is a playlist if you wanna check out all of those. I would say at least the going to Computex and the finale video are worth watching because that's a lot of the behind the scenes and the fun stuff that we did, aside from all of the like, here's the products they have on display. But I'm rambling. Thank you so much again for watching. Hit the thumbs up button if you enjoyed this video. Check out my store at paulshardware.net if you wanna help support my channel by buying yourself some merch. And we'll see you all in the next video.